My dear friends, today I will show you a phacoemulsification surgery of hypermature cataract. This patient was 32-year young female having the hypermature cataract on the right eye and immature cataract in the left eye. After making both sides side port, I am injecting the 0.6% tripan blue dye and wait for 6 to 10 seconds. Then wash the dye with the BSS and then inject 2% hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose. After injecting the HPMC, now I am making another side port on the left side. Patient is moving her eye from right to left. Now the second left sided side port is prepared. Now make a cystitome and do the rexis. I am making a rexis of small size. As I entered or pierced the capsule, some pultaceous material came out. That is obstructing my visual field. See how I am making this rexis. It is almost continuous curvilinear capsular rexis of a small size. Because the nucleus is not very hard, that's why I am not enlarging the size of the rexis. Now rexis is completed. Again inject 2% HPMC and then make a main port with the help of 2.8 steel carotid. The distance between the two ports should be at least 2.5 clock hour away. While doing the hydro procedures, the pultaceous material or liquefied cortex came out. Now inject HPMC again and just rotate the nucleus so as to make sure that there is no any corticocapsular additions. Now insert the phaco tip or phaco needle and left sided side port. Use the left sided side port for the chopping. Emulsify some superficial cortex in US1 mode and then make a trench. This is again a modified direct chop technique in which first I am making a trench of sufficient depth, and then rotate the nucleus of about 180 degree. Now go to the US2 mode, hold the nucleus with the help of vacuum, embed the phaco tip, and again divide the nucleus into heminuclei. Now rotate the two heminuclei of about 45 degree and again do the chop. This is horizontal chop. Make 2 to 3 pieces of each heminuclei, and this will help you while you will emulsifying the nuclear pieces. Now go to the US3 mode and emulsify every nuclear piece one by one. At this time phaco energy is 60, phaco power is 60, flow rate is 70, and vacuum is 350. Always be careful while emulsifying the last nuclear piece. Now after emulsifying every quadrant, take out the phaco needle and insert or inject 2% HPMC. Now clean the cortex with the help of either Cinco cannula or bimanual irrigation aspiration cannula, or you can use coaxial cannula. My dear friends, while removing or while doing this maneuver, always keep one point in your mind: don't face the aspiration port towards the posterior capsule. Never, never, and never. Subincisional cortex can be removed by going through right-sided side port. Patient is moving her eye repeatedly. Now I am injecting the HPMC and then implanting the intraocular lens. This is hydrophobic aspheric intraocular lens. While you are implanting the IUL, first implant the leading haptics into the back and dial the trailing haptics, and make sure both the haptics are in the back. Now wash the HPMC, and at this moment I am removing the few cortical fibers which are still present in between the rhexis margin and the lens. Clean HPMC thoroughly, don't leave any part of the HPMC, otherwise it will create the raised IOT post-operatively, and this will again painful to the patient and painful to the doctor also on next day. Now I have injected air bubble, and 0.1 ml pilocarpine drop, wait for the starting of pupillary constriction and then wash it thoroughly. Then inject preservative free moxifloxacin 0.1 ml from the right sided side port. And after injecting the moxifloxacin, hydrate the wound to seal the side port. Thanks for watching this video. Now surgery is concluded.